video has been created in cooperation with the Imperium Academy and Citizen One. Introducing the MISC Prospector. The MISC Prospector is a ship made for one person. The ship currently holds 4 saddlebags, which each holds 8 SCU, which in total gives you 32 SCU of space. CIG will later add mechanics for 128 SCU. The ship is not suitable for combat, however, it does have a rather strong shield and armor. The ship is armed, but not well. But do not expect to win a fight against a fighter-based ship. The ship has, however, an extraordinarily well-suitable engine for running. So if you are being hunted, you should, in most cases, be able to escape with your cargo. When you want to enter your Prospector, use the door on the port side of the ship. When you activate the door, a ladder will come down and your character will automatically start crawling up the ladder. After you crawled up the ladder, the door will automatically close behind you. Behind the door in the front of the ship, you will find the cockpit of your ship. Like in any other cases, if you want to go somewhere, you have to use the map. In this case, we want to go to Yela, because this system has an asteroid field around it. When you have arrived to the asteroid field, press Tab to get the scanning mode up. You use the scan by holding your left mouse button. When the circle is complete and you release the left mouse button, you will fire off a sensor sweep, which will show you asteroids that are nearby you that is actually capable of being mined. Use the scan continuously to see where the asteroids are. When you found them, approach them. And remember to keep using it. If you don't use the scanner continuously, the asteroids will disappear and you will be unaware of where the asteroids actually are. Note that the box that is being showed is indicating where the asteroids approximately are inside the box. Hit M to go into mining mode. As soon as you start aiming at the asteroid will be scanned. It can take a little while depending on the asteroid. The bottom left of the HUD shows the rock energy level and has 3 zones. You must be in the second zone continuously, which is also marked with a green color, until the fracture sensor meter on the bottom right reaches 100%, at which point the rock will break into smaller pieces. If you go over the second zone into the overcharge area, which is marked with the red, the overcharge sensor will quickly move up in percentage. If it reaches 100%, the rock will explode and damage or destroy your ship depending on how close you are. You need to use the mouse wheel to increase and decrease the laser throttle intensity, which is shown on the lower left side of the HUD, right above the rock energy level. If the rock energy meter doesn't move up in percentage, move your ship closer to the rock. You should see the laser create an orange ball of flame at the end. As the rock starts fracturing, you must lower the throttle because the rock will heat up faster and move you into the overcharge zone faster. When you overcharge the rock, you will get an audible and visual alert. Different mineral types and concentrations in the rock create different size fracturing sensor zones. It is easier to maintain consistent fracturing with larger zone, but risk has its rewards. The asteroid will turn into smaller pieces of rock after a successful fracture. You will notice that some of the smaller rocks have turned into either orange or purple color. The purple color means that it is ready to being extracted. Switch from fracture mode to extracting mode by right-clicking in mining mode. When you're ready, you can start extracting by left-click. Note that in the top right corner of the HUD, you will see that the percentage of the minerals inside of the asteroid is shown. You can hereby decide rather if it's worth harvesting or not. Note that the remains of the rock also goes into your cargo bay. So if it's only like 0.05% of a mineral you want, will only give you very little of the mineral you actually want, while the rest is just rock with very low value, and it just fills up the cargo space. So in the end, the higher the number is, the more mineral you will actually receive. If the asteroid is still orange, it means you have to fracture it into smaller pieces, so the extractor can extract it. When finished mining, or just simply that your cargo hold is filled, it's time for you to return to either Port Olisa or other places where you can actually drop off what you mined. The places where you sell your minerals you just mined isn't exactly the same place on every station. Here in Port Olisa, for instance, you will see the shop at the end of the hallway where you actually order the ships you want to fly in. There is a terminal on both right and left side of the shop. Go to one of these terminals. When using the terminal, on the left side of the screen you will see there is a cell from location. Here you select the prospector. An overview of what there is inside of your prospector right now is shown, so you can inspect what it is you're actually about to sell before actually selling it. Press sell when you're finished inspecting it. A window will pop up before you finish the transaction to ask you if you're actually sure if you want to do this or not.